Dear students, how are you? In this pandemic situation, I welcome you all in online chemistry class. Today, I discuss with you about a creative question of first paper of chapter 4. This chapter is important for you because from this chapter, minimum 2 creative questions will be present in board. So, let's watch the video from first to last and try to understand the creative question which I have discussed here.
Students,
okay,
let's start the class. Is N2O4, it is nitrogen tetroxide. When it decomposes, it produces nitrogen dioxide. N2O4 reversible sign to NO2 at 30 degrees Celsius temperature and 3 atm pressure. So, the temperature is 30 degrees Celsius temperature and 3 atm pressure. 15% N2O4 is decomposed. Number 2, A2 plus 3B2, the product is 2AB3 plus heat. Now, the question is, first question, derive the relation between Kp and Kc for reaction 2 of this term. That means for this reaction, this is for reaction 2. So, derive the relation between Kp and Kc for reaction 2 of this term. Number 2 question, at constant temperature if pressure is half. Students, you have seen that here one pressure is given, that is 3 atm. So, if pressure is half, that means if it is 1.5 atm, then what will be the change of rate of decomposition? You know, the rate of decomposition is denoted by alpha. So, what will be the change of rate of decomposition of N2O4? Mathematically analyze. Third question is, at equilibrium, if temperature and pressure of reaction 2, that means this reaction, is changed, then what will be the change will occur in the production of AB3? Analyze. So, let's start these 3 questions. So, students, our first question is, derive the relation between Kp and Kc for this reaction, that is A2 plus 3B2 equal to 2AB3. So, how can we derive the relation? You know, for this reaction, Kp is, first of all, partial pressure of the product, that means P of AB3 and the mole number will be the power, divided by partial pressure of the reactant. So, P of A2 into P of B2 whole cube. This is equation number 1. Again, Kc is C of AB3 at the same way. Molar concentration of the product divided by total molar concentration of the reactant. So, C of A2 into C of B2 whole cube. This is our equation number 2. You know, PV equal to nRT. This is our ideal gas equation. So, from this equation, we can write that P equal to N by VRT. That means equal to CRT. Now, we put the value of P in equation number 1. So, we get that. So, our equation 1 is Kp equal to P of AB3 whole square divided by P of A2 into P of B2 whole cube. Now, we put P, instead of P, we put CRT here. So, you can get that equal to CRT of AB3 whole square divided by CRT of A2 and CRT of B2 whole cube. So, you can divide it into the equation like that. C of AB3 whole square divided by C of A2, C of B2 whole cube, right? Into RT, it will be RT whole square divided by RT into RT whole cube. You know, students, from equation 2, you can write C of AB3 whole square divided by C of A2 into C of B2 whole cube equal to Kc. So, you can write here, it equal to Kc into, if we calculate the equation of RT, so we can get 1 by RT whole square. That means we can write Kp equal to Kc into RT to the power minus 2.
So this is the relation between Kp and Kc for equation 2, which is given here. Now students, we solve our second question. So students, our second question is, at constant temperature, if pressure is half for this reaction, then what will be the change of rate of decomposition of N2O4? Students, we have seen that here some informations are given. The informations are, at 30 degree, the reaction is occur at 30 degree Celsius temperature and 3 active ATM pressure. That means 3 atmospheric pressure. And in this temperature and in this pressure, 15% N2O4 is decomposed. So, let's calculate the rate of decomposition when pressure is half. Now students, to solve this maths, first of all, we calculate or we derive the equation of Kp for this reaction. So, for this reaction, when time is 0, mole number of N2O4 is 2 and it is 0 because the reaction is not started yet. At equilibrium, it is 1 minus alpha and it is 2 alpha. Students, you must remind that this alpha is rate of decomposition. So, we can write that total mole number. So, total mole number. Total mole number equal to 1 minus alpha plus 2 alpha. It is 1 plus alpha. Now, P of N2O4 equal to, first of all, mole number of N2O4, it is 1 minus alpha, divided by total mole number 1 plus alpha into P. Here P is total pressure. And P of NO2 equal to 2 alpha by 1 plus alpha into P. You know, Kp equal to, P of NO2 whole square divided by P of N2O4. Now we put the value here. So it will be 2 alpha P divided by 1 plus alpha whole square divided by 1 minus alpha into P divided by 1 plus alpha. Now if we solve this, we can get that. So if we solve it, we can get that Kp equal to 4 alpha square p square by 1 plus alpha whole square into 1 plus alpha divided by 1 minus alpha into p. Now if we solve it, it will be 4 alpha square p divided by 1 plus alpha into 1 minus alpha. That means 4 alpha square by 1 minus alpha square into p. This is the equation of Kp for this reaction. Now by taking this equation, we solve our maths. So students, to solve this math, first of all, we calculate the value of Kp. To calculate the value of Kp, we have taken here the value of question, what is given there, that is the value of pressure is 3 atm and 15% N2O4 is decomposed. That means here alpha is 15%. So let's start the math. We know Kp equal to 4 alpha square p by 1 minus alpha square. Here, alpha equal to 15%. That means 0.15. P equal to 3 atm. If we put it here, it will be 4 into 0.15 whole square into 3 divided by 1 minus 0.15 whole square. Now, if we calculate the value, the value is 0.2762 atm. Okay, students? Now, if pressure is half, then P equal to 3 by 2 atm. That means 1.5 atm. Okay? Now,
2. 4 alpha square p by 1 minus alpha square equal to 4 alpha square into 1.5 divided by 1 minus alpha square. So we can write. So we can write here Kp equal to 0.2762 equal to 6 alpha square by 1 minus alpha square. Okay? Equal to 0.2762 into 1 minus alpha square equal to 6 alpha square. So you can write 6 alpha square plus 0.2762 alpha square equal to 0.2762. Okay? So it will be 6.2762 alpha square equal to 0.2762. So here alpha equal to root over 0.2762 by 6.2762. So here alpha equal to 0.2097. That means 20.97%. So students, what you have seen? At 3 atm pressure and 30 degree Celsius temperature, the alpha is 15%. But here it is 20.97%. That means the rate of decomposition is increased. So here actually the rate of decomposition is 6% increase. So the rate of decomposition is 20.97 minus 15% or 5.97% increased. So this is the answer of our second question. Now start our third question. So our third question is, what will if the temperature and pressure, if temperature and pressure of this reaction is changed at equilibrium, then what will be the change of production, rate of production of this reaction? So students, first of all, you have seen that here A2 plus 3 B2 reversible sign, 2 AVG plus heat. Plus heat means here when the reaction occurred, that means when the reaction goes forward, then heat is evolved. As here heat is evolved, that means it is an exothermic reaction. I repeat again, it is an exothermic reaction. That means if the reaction goes forward, then heat is evolved. And if the reaction goes backward, then heat is absorbed. So according to La Chatelier principle, you know, if any stress is applied to a system, then the system will move in such a direction to relieve the stress. That means in an exothermic reaction, if we increase the heat, then the reaction will move in such a way to relieve the excess heat, right? Now, if temperature of this reaction is increased. So, first of all, I have discussed here about temperature. If temperature of this reaction is increased, then the reaction will move in backward direction. That means here amount of reactant will increase. That means amount of product will decrease here. If we increase the temperature, then the production of product will decrease. Okay. Again, if we decrease the temperature, I repeat again, if we decrease the temperature, then the reaction will move forward. The reaction will move forward. If the reaction moves forward, that means here production of AB3 will increase, right? So here we make 2 points. First of all, if temperature is decreased, then the reaction moves forward. So students, if temperature is increased, the reaction will move backward. You know, if the reaction moves backward, that means
the amount of reactant will increase. Amount of reactant will increase and amount of product will decrease. That means here the production of Ab2 will hampered. If temperature is decreased, then the reaction will move forward. If the reaction move forward, then amount of product will increase. So this is the effect of temperature on the reaction. Now let's discuss about the pressure. Students, you know, pressure is totally depend on mole number. So here you have seen that 1 mole A2 reacts with 3 mole B2. That means here total mole number is 4. And here it produces 2 mole AB3. That means in reactant total mole number is 4. In product total mole number is 2. So if we increase pressure, the reaction will move forward. If the reaction move forward, then amount of product will increase. If we decrease pressure, then the reaction will move backward. That means the amount of reactant will increase. That means the amount of product will decrease. Clear? So the pressure effect is if pressure is increased, the reaction will move forward. That means the production of AB3 will increase. If pressure is decreased, the reaction will move backward. Backward means the amount of reactant will increase and the amount of product will decrease. So this is the effect of temperature and pressure on the given reaction. Okay students, no more today. Hope all of you understand the creative question which I have discussed in my class.